We're back with the program that prints out my array of friends, but there's something that really annoys me about it. Every time I add a new friend to the array, I have to add a new text command down here. So let's say I add Winston. Well, he doesn't automatically show up. If I want him to show up, I have to go and say tags my friends 3 and then change the Y position and then let me see Winston. Okay. So that's way too much work. I just want so that every time I add someone else to the array, it does the text command automatically. Well, do you remember when we learned loops? Loops were a great way to repeat the same bit of code many times in a row, like if we wanted to have a bunch of trees in a row or a bunch of balloons. Well, as it turns out, loops are also a great way to run a bit of code on each element in an array. In fact, you'll use a loop almost every time you use an array. They work really well together. So let's use a loop to display my friends' names instead of having all these text commands to show you what I mean. So we'll start with the 3 questions we always ask ourselves when we're making a loop. First, what do I want to repeat? Well, look up here, what's repeated? The text command. What do I want to change each time? Well, we just look and see what's different. So the Y position and the current index, right? So, you know, the friend num and the Y position. And how long should we repeat? Well, we keep going until there are no more friends. Okay, so now we know what we want, and we can make our loop. We start off with a counter variable to keep track of where we are in the loop. So we'll say var friend num equals 0. And we're going to start with 0, because remember that 0 is the first element in the array, not 1. Then we have our while loop. So we'll say while friend num, and we'll say less than myFriends.length. So we're going to compare the current counter variable to the total number of things in the array. And inside the loop, that's where we use our text command. So we say text myFriends, and then here, instead of a number, we're going to put friendNum, because friendNum represents the current number. And then we'll just put 1 position for now. Okay, so this is giving us the little infinite loop error because we haven't actually changed anything about friendNum. Remember, we need to increment friendNum each time, otherwise the loop will go on forever because that condition's always true. Okay, so I see something happen. Let me comment out the old code so I can really see what's happened. So what we have is we've showed all the names, but they're all on top of each other. So we need to change our Y position. So let's just say friendNum times 30. Okay, that's good, but Sophia's off the screen, and Sophia's not going to be very happy if she finds that out. So let's just add 30 to that. So now they're all offset by 30. Beautiful. So now you see we have a loop displaying our array. And that means if we add more people, like Oh No's guy, or maybe even Sal, if I just add him to the array, then Sal will be my friend. Awesome. Now he's my buddy. And you see that it just automatically shows the new friends because it's always going through the whole array. So we can delete our old code. We don't need that anymore. And let's just go through this code here and review what it does. So we start off with friendNum equal to 0. We check to see if friendNum is less than the current length, right? So you imagine 0 is less than 6. That's true. So then we go inside here and we say text my friend's friendNum. So that'll be my friend 0 the first time. And then 30 plus 0 times 30. So it displays Sophia at 10 and 30. So that's what it does. And then friendNum plus plus, so then it becomes 1. And then it goes back around and says, okay, is 1 less than my friends at length? Yeah, it is. And it keeps going. And then finally, you know, we get to Sal. Sal, remember, Sal is actually the 6th element in the array, but he's index 5, right? Since we start at 0. So is 5 less than 6? Yes. So it displays my friends 5, and then it becomes 6, and we say, oh, is 6 less than 6? No, it's equal, right? So this will be false. So it will never display the 6th element, which is good, because there is nothing in index 6, right? There's a 6th element, but nothing at index 6. It can be really confusing, the fact that it's, 0 and 1 and doing all that, but you'll get the hang of it. All right, so that's our loop. Now, if you want to, you can actually use a for loop as well, if you prefer for loops. So for a for loop, we'll just say for, and then var friendNum equals 0, and then we have our condition, friendNum is less than myFriends.length, and then our increment, friendNum++, And then inside the for loop, we can just put just this line of code here. And I'll just change the x so that you can see it does exactly the same thing, right? So it's up to you which one you use, but the point is to use a loop with your arrays because it will make you so powerful.